Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'll explain how easy it is to add the Syncfusion Blazor breadcrumb component to a Blazor WebAssembly application. I'll show you how to add items, icons, and custom templates, and also breadcrumb navigation. Let me start with the application creation process. A Blazor application can be created using Visual Studio 2019, Visual Studio Code, or JetBrains Writer. In this video, I'll show you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application using Visual Studio 2019. Make sure that you have installed it along with .NET Core SDK 3.1.8 or .NET 5.0 SDK. .NET Core SDK 3.1.8 requires Visual Studio 2019 version 16.7 or later, whereas .NET 5.0 requires Visual Studio 2019 version 16.8 or later. I'll open Visual Studio 2019 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Then, choose the Blazor WebAssembly app and click the Next button. I will name my project and click Next. Then select the target framework as .NET Core 5.0 and click the Create button. The project has been created and is ready for use. Now, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding the breadcrumb component to this project. First, I need to install the syncfusion.blazor.navigations package to work with the breadcrumb component. To do that, I'll open the NuGet package manager, search for the package, and install it in my application. Once installed, you can see the package added to this application's packages folder. Then, navigate to the _imports.razor page and import the syncfusion.blazor.navigations namespace. Then I need to register for the Syncfusion Blazor services. In the program.cs file, import the syncfusion.blazor namespace and register the Syncfusion Blazor service using the @syncfusionblazor method. I also need to register the license using the syncfusion.licensing.syncfusionlicenseprovider.registerlicense method to avoid the license validation message. Next, navigate to the index.html page within the root folder to add a Syncfusion Bootstrap 4 reference from the installed package. The configuration steps are done, so let's move on to adding the Blazor breadcrumb component. I will open the index.razor page and add the SF breadcrumb tag. Let me run the application. See here, a breadcrumb is rendered based on the current URL if items are not specified. Since I have added the control on the home page, only the home icon is shown. For better understanding, I will paste this tag in the fetchdata.razor page and show you. You can see the difference in rendering the control here and on the home page. This is the default behavior. Let me show you how to add items to the breadcrumb. First, include the breadcrumb items tag to add multiple items. Then add the breadcrumb item tag to specify a single item. Here I'm going to display a home icon. So, add the icon CSS property and specify the icon name e-icons e-home. Then to navigate, I add URL property and specify the absolute URL of a Syncfusion Blazor breadcrumb demo sample. Here I have added only one item in breadcrumb, so it acts as an active item. I need to enable navigation on active items by setting the enable active item navigation value to true. Look here, an item is added to the breadcrumb with a provided icon. When you click this icon, it will redirect you to the Syncfusion Blazor breadcrumb demo page. You can also add an image using the icon CSS property. Refer to the UG link provided in the description below. Next, I will add another breadcrumb item tag. Here, I add the text property to specify the text to be displayed in the item and set its value to navigation. Add the URL property and specify the relative URL to display the counter page in this application. Look here, an item navigation is added. When you click this item, it will redirect you to the counter page in this application. Finally, I will show you how to customize breadcrumb items and separators using templates. I add the breadcrumb templates tag to customize its items. Then add the item template tag to customize the item. Here I'm going to show the items with the button component. So, use the Syncfusion Blazor buttons package. Then add the SF button tag. I add an anchor tag in the button for navigation. I can access the item text using the implicit context parameter. In the same way, I can access the URL and assign it to the href property. Then I remove the icon CSS property and add the text property with value as home. Since we are going to use this button for navigation, I add the CSS class property and assign the built-in class e-link. Check now, items are customized as buttons in the breadcrumb. Notice the button appearance is changed to link. And I can navigate now. I'll inspect the element and show the button in the breadcrumb item. To customize the separator, I need to use the separator template tag. Here, I'm going to show the arrow as a separator. So, define a font icon in the class eArrow and use it in the span class. Look here, the breadcrumb separator is customized based on the template. Now, let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app and add the Syncfusion breadcrumb component to it. Then I showed you a few basic features like adding items, icons, and custom templates, and also breadcrumb navigation. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.